on slavery and genocide. That was the origins of this country. Those of us who are not Native American or who were not African Americans brought here in chains all came later as immigrants. But this is a country grounded in slavery and genocide first. But we are also a different country. Like the great Howard Zinn taught us, we are the country of genocide and slavery, but we are also the country of movements against genocide and slavery. We fought back, and we are here tonight. We are here tonight standing on the shoulders of all of those who went before, fighting against genocide, fighting against slavery, fighting for women's rights, fighting for the environment, fighting against wars, all of the fights that have characterized our people's movements for so many years. Why is Islamophobia on the rise right now? It's part of racism. It's been around a long time. But it's not an accident that it's Islamophobia in particular that is on the rise right now because of war. Because the wars that Ryan and Ali were just talking about, the wars we've been hearing about all night, just happen to be waged against countries that are predominantly Muslim countries. The seven countries singled out for greater punishment in this set of punishments we've been hearing about in recent days. Of those seven, the US is today bombing five, stationing troops at US bases in one, and sanctioning the last. We are at war with those seven countries, and Islamophobia is necessary to build public support for those wars. When we stop Islamophobia, the wars become impossible. So we have a very big job to do. We welcome refugees here. We say stop the ban on refugees. Bring in more refugees. It was a travesty last year that our government bragged about welcoming 10,000 refugees from Syria when there are hundreds of thousands in grave need and where our government is one of the many forces responsible. And what we heard was, wasn't it great that we were going to take 10,000 at a time when Germany was taking 20,000 a day that summer? What a tragedy that was, and what a travesty for our government to brag about. So we have a big job to do to say, we don't think it's okay for refugees to come here. We think it's necessary for refugees to come here. We're not okay with refugees coming. We're not going to grudgingly welcome them and say, well, yes, dear, it's all right, we'll give you a warm coat. We are demanding that our children have the right to go to school with Syrians and Palestinians and people from all over the world, most especially from those countries that our country has been bombing. We have been at war with terrorism for 15 years, and terrorism is doing just fine. It's the people in the countries that we're bombing that are paying the price. It's not making us safer. It's not making them safer. It's putting us all at greater risk. So our second obligation, after saying that we need to bring in far more refugees, we need to pay far more money to the refugee agencies. You know, the United States has 28% of the wealth of the world, and we are only 5% of the population. Doesn't that mean that we should be paying at least 28% of the bill for the refugees in such desperate straits around the world as a starting point? But we have another job to do. And that job is to end the wars that are creating refugees. Refugees don't just happen. Refugee flows are the result of climate catastrophes and military wars around the world. And it's ending those wars that will deal with the challenge we face today, where we have 65 million people displaced around the world, 25 million refugees, 40 million internally displaced because of wars that our government, as Dr. Martin Luther King taught us, the biggest purveyor of violence in the world. It was true then, and it's true today. We have an obligation to end those wars if we are serious about helping refugees. We have to start by saying we welcome them here, but our next step has to be to end the wars that forced them to become refugees in the first place. No refugee. To a place that is not their home. People want to live in their own homes. It's our obligation to make it possible for them to do so. We have a lot of work to do. Thank you very much. Yeah.